Okay, we have got a special rehab session with you today because we have got our newest physio, Fran McCurdy, with us today.
Hi.
She's a senior physio and she's now joined the team, and she's going to show us what we're doing with Beck, who's holding the camera, about her pregnancy problem with the SIJ and the lower back pain, and we'll go from there. So
what we've found with Beck at the moment, she is actually quite hypermobile, which means her sacroiliac joint is moving around quite a lot due to the ligament relaxation that's happening. So what we are trying to do with her at the moment is stabilize the muscles that surround her sacroiliac joint and fire them up so that we can get more stability around this joint. So the main muscles we're trying to work on with her are the pelvic floor and the transabs, which are the deep stabilizing muscles around the spine and around the pelvis, as well as the big glute muscles that sit around the SIJ to stabilize it. So some of the exercises that we do, we always start with our mat work first to get the pre-activation, warm all the muscles up, and then we can take that up into standing exercises. So the first one that we have been doing with Beck is her pelvic tilts. So what we're doing with this one is we're trying to get a little bit of lower back mobility while creating the stability with the pelvic floor and the transabs kicking in. So the way that we're doing this is we take a nice deep breath in. We're breathing out. As she takes a breath out, she's going to activate the pelvic floor, and she'll feel a nice tightening around the lower section of her belly, which activates the transabs, and then we're rolling the pelvis backwards. We're not lifting it up at all, we're literally just creating a rolling action of the pelvis backwards. Okay, so we've been doing this around 10 to 20 times. And then what we do from here is we take that up into a bridge. So we actually do that by getting a little bit more activation of the glutes using a band. So I'm going to slip the band on. Okay, so by putting a bit of resistance on the outside of her knees, she has to push against that, and then we're really switching on the lateral rotators in the hips and the glute muscles, okay? So we've got all the muscles firing up here. So what we're going to do is we're going to go into that pelvic tilt again. So we're going to take a breath in, we're going to breathe out, activate the pelvic floor, and we're going to start to roll the pelvis back. Then what we're going to do is we're going to push out nice and gently against the bend. We're going to squeeze the butt muscles, drive the heels down through the floor, and just gently roll the spine up into a bridge. At the top, we take a breath in, and then we're breathing out, starting to roll down one vertebra at a time from the top, and then just gently allowing tailbone to drop down at the end. So we're going to do that one more time. So we're breathing out, so we're rolling the pelvis back. Good, taking a breath in at the top, then we're breathing out as we come down. So one vertebrae at a time, keeping the pelvis nice and high, and then we're allowing the tailbone to drop down at the end. Okay? From the bridges, we then go on to doing some side work. So we're going to work on the glute muscles. So I'm going to get to face that way, so the camera's there. Yeah, that's the other side. Okay, so I'm sure you've seen this one probably a million times, but these are your clamps. Okay, again, we're working on not just your hip muscles with this, but the challenge is to really keep the core and pelvis stable by using your core muscles, okay? So when we're doing this clamp work, we don't want to see any shifting or moving of the pelvic or the pelvis itself. We probably just want hip joint movement, okay? So in the side lying position, it's going to get a little bit of length just through her side, just by getting her to lift a little bit. Her on the floor. Okay, we're going to drive the heels together. We're getting that pre-activation, so pelvic floor, we're going to tighten that. We're going to feel that nice drawing up, okay, around the lower belly of the transabs. And then we're going to lift that knee up towards the ceiling with no movement or rolling back of this top pelvis here. Okay, then we're going to drop it down. Just before we touch, we're going to come back up again. So breathe out, drive it up, and then we're going to slowly lower down. And just before we touch, we're going to breathe out, we're going to drive that up, okay? The key with this is going nice and slowly, especially on the way down, okay? It's quite easy when the band is there to let your knees just snap shut,
yeah.
Okay? But we want that control there, yeah? That really
And a lot of people, a lot of people use too much sort of hip flexor and TFL, don't they, to
yeah.
do it?
Yeah, exactly.
So you've got to squeeze from the back.
So this one's really, really good. It's also quite a comfortable position for people as well. We don't tend to keep them on their backs for too long. Okay, because it puts a lot of compressive force on some of the arteries that run through this section there. Okay, so from here we're then going on into a more long lever exercise. So we're going on into an exercise called a hip abduction or side leg lift. So it's going to bend the bottom leg. Okay, again, let's get this position set up right first. So this top pelvis needs to be rolled forward, so it's just slightly in front of the lower one. Again, we want to keep this length here between the pelvis and between the ribs. So the action of this exercise is to pre-activate the core again, so let's tighten that pelvic floor. Let's see that drawing up of the core muscles. We're going to slowly start to lift the leg up towards the ceiling, but we're keeping this length here between the pelvis and the ribs. A lot of people tend to crunch this area down. Okay, so make sure we keep that nice and long, and then slowly lower down. Yes. Okay, and then we're lifting again. Lift, lift, lift. Good, and then lower down. Let's try to keep a little bit more length in there. That's it, good. And again, nice and slowly with both the up and the downward motion as well. Making sure there's nothing shifting and moving around through here. And we're keeping that nice, gentle pelvic floor activation through the whole movement as well, okay? So what we're going to do from here, we're going to move up into some standing work, okay? So we always like to do our mat work first, get everything fired up, and start getting all the stability there, and then we can take that up into more functional positions.